everybody. My name is Moss, and welcome back to this tutorial series on GitLab. In the last video, we discussed the differences between Jenkins and GitLab CI, and I walked you through a sample migration from a Jenkins pipeline to a GitLab pipeline. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to some additional features of GitLab pipelines. We are going to cover the packaging and releasing features of GitLab. Let's review our learning objectives for this module. After completing this module, you should be able to do the following. Deploy artifacts from a GitLab pipeline to the GitLab package registry. Describe GitLab releases. Describe the GitLab package, container, and infrastructure registries. A software release in a GitLab project may include the following. Generic software packages generated from GitLab pipeline job artifacts, such as platform-specific binaries. Release notes. Release evidence that includes everything associated with the release, such as issues, milestones, or test reports. And by default, a snapshot of the GitLab project's source code. Now let's talk about the registries available in GitLab, starting with the package registry. The GitLab package registry allows you to use GitLab as a public or private software package registry. And the registry supports a number of package managers. You can publish and share software packages to the registry. And these packages can be published from within a CI/CD pipeline. Packages are associated to a GitLab project and groups that project is added to. The GitLab container registry is a private container registry for publishing and consuming container images. And every GitLab project has its own container registry. The container images in the registry are associated with a GitLab project and any groups that project has been added to. You can utilize container images stored in the registry from a GitLab pipeline. You can also build and publish container images to the registry from a GitLab pipeline. Lastly, we have the infrastructure registry, which supports publishing and sharing of Terraform modules. Each GitLab project has an infrastructure registry, and you can build and publish a Terraform module from a GitLab pipeline. Now that we've defined releases and the available registries in GitLab, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I'd like to do is quickly walk through the code base that we're going to be using today. And once we've done that, we'll then write a GitLab pipeline for our code base. I'm currently logged into GitLab, and I'm inside of the test pipeline project. The test pipeline code base should be pretty familiar to you if you've been following this series. It's a Maven project that was generated using the quick start Maven archetype. If we take a look at the source directory, it has a single app.java class, and it simply prints out hello world to the console. Okay, and then it has one matching test class as well. But what's more relevant to review in this video is the ci_settings.xml file and the pom.xml file, because inside of these files, we have configurations that are going to be used by the GitLab pipeline that we write. The ci_settings.xml file is used as our Maven settings.xml file. So let's quickly take a look at the settings. And inside of our settings, we define a server configuration with an ID of GitLab-Maven. And then we also define a property with the name job-token. And its value actually references a predefined GitLab environment variable. So this is how we would reference a GitLab environment variable from within a file. And this variable is called ci_job_token. This predefined environment variable is one of several ways that we can authenticate with the GitLab package registry. If we want to authenticate with the GitLab package registry from within a GitLab pipeline, then we would want to use the CI job token to do that. However, if we want to authenticate with the package registry outside of a GitLab pipeline, so we're authenticating from a Jenkins pipeline or even from our local machine, what we would want to use is either a personal access token, a GitLab personal access token that we generated for our account, and that has to have the scope of API access, or we need a deploy token that's generated from our GitLab project. And the value of either the deploy token or the personal access token has to be used in place of the CI job token, since we're authenticating from outside of a GitLab pipeline. But in our case, we are going to write a GitLab pipeline. So I'm going to use the CI_job_token environment variable to authenticate with the package registry so that we can deploy a Maven package to the project's registry. And one thing that I'd like to point out before we move on is that this code base will be made available to you. Okay, so now let's take a look at the pom.xml file. Inside of the pom.xml file, I modified the version tag. And again, I'm referencing a predefined GitLab environment variable called CI_commit_tag. So when we write the GitLab pipeline, we're going to configure the pipeline to run anytime a Git tag is pushed or created in our GitLab project. So the pipeline is going to reference the environment variable, and so will the pom.xml file when it generates a snapshot. The other thing that was modified in this pom.xml file is the repositories tag. So we added a repositories tag, and it specifies the GitLab Maven package registry URL. And to form the package registry URL, we use GitLab predefined environment variables again. And in this case, you can see the first environment variable that's referenced is CI_API_v4_URL. So this is going to be the API URL for GitLab, followed by projects, followed by the next predefined environment variable, which is our GitLab project's ID, CI_project_ID. And then we specify packages and then Maven. Okay, so now that we've reviewed the pom.xml file and the CI_settings.xml file, we can start writing a GitLab pipeline that deploys this this Maven codebase as a Maven package to this GitLab project's package registry. So what I'm going to do now is navigate to the pipeline editor. So under CICD, I'll select editor. And then I'm going to select create new CICD pipeline. Okay, and the first thing that I want to do is delete all of the stuff that we don't need in this pipeline template. So I'll delete the comments. And then I'm going to delete the build and test stage and just leave the deploy stage. So I'll remove all of the jobs associated with the test and build stage. So we only have the deploy stage and the single deploy job. Now in this case, since we're just demonstrating the package registry feature in GitLab, I'm removing the build and test stage, but of course in a production and pipeline, you want to keep the build and test stage in addition to the deploy stage. And after removing those stages, I'm going to define the Docker image that the deploy job should use when executing the steps inside of the deploy job. So at the top of the pipeline definition, I'm going to specify the image keyword, and then I'm going to specify the Maven image and the latest version of the Maven image. The next thing that I want to do is define the relevant pipeline variables. So under stages, I'm going to define the variables keyword. And under variables, we are going to have a single variable called Maven_options. And this is going to specify our local repo. So dmaven repo local, and then $CI_project_directory. So this is a predefined environment variable that we can use. And then the .m2 repository. And after defining the variables, I'm going to use a keyword that we haven't used in previous videos, and that is the workflow keyword. The workflow keyword is used to control the behavior of the pipeline. And under the workflow keyword, we can specify the rules keyword. And rules essentially create conditions on which the pipeline will either be ran or not ran. And in our case, we're going to define a single rule. So under the rules keyword, I'm going to put hyphen, and then I'll put the conditional if statement. And then I'm going to put $CI_commit_tag. So what this rule is saying is that this pipeline will run if it was triggered by the creation of a git tag. Either a git tag was pushed to the project, or we created a git tag manually from the repository section and then the tags page. Now, after specifying the workflow rules, we will create a cache using the cache keyword. So under workflow, I'm going to use the cache keyword, and we'll specify paths. And we'll specify one path, which will be .m2 repository. And then the final thing that we need to do is actually invoke Maven in the deploy job. So in the deploy job, I'm going to remove this first statement here, and we are going to invoke Maven, and then we'll say Maven deploy, and then specify the settings file using -s CI_settings.xml. And then I'll also remove these comments here. So if I wrote this pipeline correctly, it should publish the Maven package to this GitLab project's package registry. And it says that this is a valid GitLab CI configuration. So let's go ahead and commit this pipeline and then see if it runs successfully. So I'm going to navigate down here and I'll select commit changes. And based on the workflow keyword, this shouldn't run automatically until we've created a new tag in the repository. So let's navigate to the pipelines page. And you can see that no pipeline has started yet. So I'm going to navigate to the repository section and then to the tags page. And from here, I'm going to select new tag. And we'll give the tag name version 1.0.0. And we'll create it from the main branch. I'll leave the message blank and release notes blank for now. And then I'll select create tag. Okay, so that created a new git tag. And if I navigate back to CICD and then pipelines, that triggered a new pipeline job. So I'm going to open up that pipeline job. And we have the single deploy job. So I'm going to open up the deploy job and let's take a look at the output. Okay, so it looks like the pipeline completed successfully. And if we take a look at the output, I won't go through all of the output, but starting at line 614, we can see where Maven deploy started. And on line 617, we can see where it started uploading the Maven package to the URL that we specified in the pom.xml file. And you can see in the URL how it expanded the predefined environment variables, like the API URL for GitLab, as well as the GitLab project ID right here. And then also the tag version name as well. So it appears that it successfully uploaded our Maven package to this project's package registry. And to verify that, let's go to the packages and registries section, and then I'm going to navigate to the package registry page. And from this page, you can see that we have one package available, and it's associated with the v1.0.0 tag, and it's a Maven package. So if I were to open the package up, we can see all of the details related to this Maven package. So on this page, it provides a history of the package, and it also shows me how to add this package as a dependency in a downstream project, and also how to set up this registry, this GitLab project's registry in my pom.xml file. And then I can also access the files associated with this Maven package. So that's pretty much all I had for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next series. If you'd like to learn more, be sure to follow our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our Lambda Test community at community.lambdatest.com. You can also earn resume-worthy Lambda Test Selenium certifications at lambdatest.com/certifications.